يا إخوتي هيا نمضي سويا، 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 يا إخوتي هيا نمضي سويا سويا سويا، يا إخوتي هيا نمضي 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 سويا.
بسعي الحديث لأجل البناء، لأجل الرقي،
بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أما بعد. In the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, indeed all praise and gratitude be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As such, we ask Allah to send his peace and blessing upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon his entire family, his noble companion, and those who follow him in his footsteps to the day of judgment Amma ba'd. Brother and sister, I'd like to welcome you to the Plain Truth TV. I'm your host, Abu Muhammad Ali Al-Ansari. I'd like to welcome you with Islamic greeting. Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh wa maghfira. I hope you're in good iman and good health. Welcome to our show tonight, which is advice, reminder, warning, and glad tidings. We advise Muslims concerned about different situations they're in. We remind Muslims concerned about the obligation that Allah and His Messenger has made obligatory upon us. And we warn Muslims against anything that is detrimental to their deens, to the akhirah, and to the worldly life. And lastly, we encourage Muslims to do this that is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they have a great reward hereafter. Welcome to our show tonight. Tonight's show is basically reflection that I want to ask you a question. I want all of us to ask ourselves this question. The question, and we think about it and be honest with ourselves while reflecting deeply on it. One of the questions that I want to ask you is that, what is the greatest gift, greatest blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestow upon you? You as a Muslim, what do you consider is the best gift, the greatest gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon you? I want you to think about it. Take a minute, sit down and think about it. Think about it deeply. Really, really think about it. It is very important and it is very urgent that we reflect on this. What is the greatest gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon us as a Muslim? So we think about it. Truly, if we are Muslim, as we really claim to be Muslim, we all will conclude that the greatest gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon us is nothing other than Islam. Islam is the greatest gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon us. Truly, Islam is the greatest gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon us. Some of us might have been thinking that it's our family. We know that having family is also a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but it can never be compared to Islam. For your family will die, your family will go away, or you will die and you will leave your family here. And also, some people don't even have families. So think about it. That could not be the only greatest gift that you can have. Some people think of maybe health. Health is indeed a great, mighty blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but how many people have health by they misuse their health by doing the wrong things? So it could be detrimental also, having been healthy and misusing it. Some people think of time, having free time, ability to do things in the free time. This is indeed a great blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also, but it can be detrimental if you don't have no guidance, you don't have a set of guidance to show you how to live, how to utilize your time wisely. It could be detrimental for you in this life and hereafter. Some people was probably thinking of wealth, material possession. Material possession is really a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But however, if you misuse it, if you don't have no guidelines how to utilize it to benefit you in this life and hereafter, it could be detrimental for you also. Some people was thinking of being alive. This is one of the greatest gifts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon us. Yes, indeed, it is one of the greatest, is one of great blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given us. But what is the purpose of having life when you don't know the purpose beyond life? You don't even know the set of guidance how to live life properly. So as we see that all of these are blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they have their own limitation. But however, Islam being a complete way of life, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent for the guidance, as a guidance for mankind. It is indeed the greatest blessing that us as a Muslim has received. For truly those who study Islam and understand Islam and practice Islam understand that the greatest gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ever bestowed upon mankind is Islam. Nothing more and nothing less is Islam. So brothers and sisters, I want us to ask ourselves, since we know that the greatest gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon us, let us ask ourselves and look at our life, where we are right now. What is it that we're doing right now? The question is, on the day of judgment, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you and ask us, the greatest gift that I bestowed upon you is Islam. So what did you do with it? Brother and sister, let us sincerely and be honest with ourselves and ask this question. This gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us, this blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us, which is set as a guideline for, as a guidance for us, to protect us from anything that is harmful for us in this life, to guide us through to the trials and tribulations of this life, to make us successful in Akhirah, as a means of leading us to a successful life in Akhirah. This great gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us, this gift which protects us from drinking alcohol, from fornicating, from intoxication, from drugs, for trying to be polluted with music, with intoxicants. This blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon us, which protects our heart from spiritual disease, such as envy, jealousy, grudge, hatred, so on and so forth. These spiritual disease, hypocrisies. This blessing of Islam, which encourages spiritual moral values, such as goodness, charity, righteousness, generosity, kindness, compassion, forgiving, forbearing, subhanallah al-azim. The list go on. This blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us to protect us in this life and to guide us on this life, to guide us to the hereafter, to give us, to protect us and give us a good life in this life, and also to protect us in the trials and tribulations of this life, to guide us in hereafter, so we may succeed. So this blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us, I want you and I to think about it. What is it that we did with it? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks us on the day of judgment, I have given you this blessing, this ni'mah, this greatest blessing that I have given you, what did you do with it? Brother and sister, let us sit down and think about it. What have we done for Islam? On the day of judgment, if Allah asks us, before Allah asks us on the day of judgment, let us sit down and think about it where we are right now. Sincerely, this gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us, what have you done for it? What have you done with it? This blessing of Islam. Really sincerely think about it. You need to look at your life. We need to look at our life. What is it that we have done for Islam? What is it that we have done for Islam? What is it that we have done for Islam? Think about it. Whatever answer that you're going to come up with, look at your life. Are you living the answer that you're giving? Look at your life. Are you living the answer that you're giving? Are you really living the life that you say, the answer that you're giving, the answer that you will give to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You might say, well, I try to live the best way I can. Now, truly ask yourself, are you living the best way that you can? Are you living Islamically all your whole life? You're striving hard to live Islamically as possible as you can? Are you doing the best that you can? Brothers and sisters, so these are things that we have to think about it. We really have to think about it before the day of judgment. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can send each of us a ticket any moment. We can leave this world any moment, any minute. It takes 9 months to be born, but it only takes a few seconds to die, to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let us think about it. What is it that we're doing in this life? What is it that we're doing with our life? What is it that we're doing, this gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon us? Brothers and sisters, let us sincerely and think about it. You could be doing what with this blessing? You could be learning the deen of Islam, learning it, understanding it, implementing it, calling people to it. These are means of showing your appreciation for the deen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you a blessing. This great blessing is encouraged in Islam. by the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he said that you will not believe until you love for your brother what you love for yourself. So for mankind, every mankind in general, we are descendants of Adam. So we should love for them what we love for ourselves. This great blessing of Islam, we should share with other people. If we don't have the talent or ability to share with other people, at least try to learn the deen and practice it to the best of your ability. Teach it to your family and implement the moral teaching of Islam in your life and live like a Muslim. And be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has given you and I this blessing of Islam, brother and sister. So this is a short reminder, brother and sister, that I wanted to share with you to reflect on our life, where we are right now. Where are we right now, brother and sister? What is it that we're doing? Are we getting prepared to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when He calls us any minute? Are we prepared to turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Are we prepared to show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the gift He has given us, that we are grateful for it, that we're going to utilize in the right way, brother and sister? So this short reminder was concerned about that. Whatever good that you have heard, it is indeed by the mercy and the guidance and the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever error and mistake that you have heard, it is indeed from me and Shaitan, not Allah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive me and have mercy on us and guide us to the straight path, and make our best deed our last deed, and protect us from shirk, kufr, bidah, hypocrisy, major and minor sin, and make us to die on tawheed. I will conclude here. Subhanaka bihamdihi ashara la ilaha anta wa astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh wa maghfira.
دستورنا 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 القرآن، من يرتضي أن ينتمي لعدوه شيطان. دستورنا 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 القرآن، من يرتضي أن ينتمي لعدوه شيطان.
وفداء أرواحنا وقتيله ريحان، وشهيدنا بدمائه في جنة الرضوان. وفداء أرواحنا وقتيله ريحان، وشهيدنا بدمائه في جنة الرضوان. وهداية لشعوبنا ولكفرهم خذلان وشفاء